الله 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 الله.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to yet another episode of Islam in Focus. Alhamdulillah, it is this beautiful month of Ramadan, and here we are talking to Brother Ehsan Iqbal Patel about things we need to do, things we need to be careful about, things, the activities that we need to do in this month of Ramadan. And one of the core activities, one of the most important things when it comes to this Ramadan, and not just in Ramadan, alhamdulillah, we need to do this throughout the year as mu'min and as Muslims. This is something that we all talk about so much. It is istighfar and repenting for our sins. Brother Ehsan, assalamu alaikum, and welcome to the show once again. How important is it for a Muslim to repent?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Yes, if we talk about the repentance, about the istighfar, it is much important because we people are always getting engaged in committing sins. So for people like us, we should have the practice of repentance as well. And it doesn't mean that we go and go, we often commit sins and ask for the repentance. No. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu toobu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has stated that, O believers, seek repentance and sincerely, with the intention of not committing that again. So if a person repents in such a way, then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will not forgive his sins, but again his sins will be transferred towards the good deeds, and again Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will be pleased with that person. Allah ta'ala has stated that, I am willing to forgive all the sins of you except shirk, that is, except you associate any partner with me. Subhanallah. So alhamdulillah, no Muslims associate Allah with a partner, because it is in hadith Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated that, I have no fear about my ummah that they will commit a shirk, but they will be engaged in fitna. Subhanallah. So our Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam has also said that, there is no fear from my ummah to commit a shirk. Allahu Akbar. So Allah Ta'ala has stated, inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bih. Allah will never forgive the one who commits a shirk, a partner with Allah. Wa yaghfiru ma duna dhalika liman yasha, and will forgive all the sins of a person. Whatever Allah likes, Allah will forgive all those. And if a person is engaged in repentance, Allah Ta'ala likes that so much that it comes like this. If you refer to the hadith, I'm just giving you the meaning of the hadith. Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam has stated about the repentance, that if a person commits a sin and if he seek repentance, then Allah Ta'ala says to angels, he takes me as a forgiver, as Ra'uf and Rahim, as a Rahman and Rahim. So he is repenting from me, asking repentance from me, because he takes me as a forgiver, as Rahim. So why not I forgive him? Allahu Akbar. So again, if that person commits a sin, like he repents sincerely, but again, due to his weakness, if he commits a sin again, and again, if he seek repentance, then again Allah says, Allahu Akbar, to the angels, he is seeking forgiveness from me because he knows that I am the forgiver. He takes me as a forgiver, Rahman and Rahim, Allahu Akbar. Again, Allah Ta'ala forgives that person. So see, by repenting from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, how Allah Ta'ala forgives sins. It is like that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is pleased with that person who is seeking repentance, because he is taking Allah as the creator, he is taking Allah as the forgiver, he is taking Allah as the Malik, the owner of everything. So when he remembers Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala with all these words of attributes, like if he say, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, I seek your forgiveness, then indeed Allah ta'ala will forgive. And again, it is mentioned in hadith, before asking dua, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, you praise Allah first, then you send salawat on me, on Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then you ask for dua. Indeed, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will accept your duas. Because if you ask from Allah by naming him few attributes, then inshallah al-aziz, Allah ta'ala will forgive the sins. And again, about the repentance, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, if a person has got sins equal to the ocean or equal to the trees of the earth, what is going to the meaning of this is, any amount he may have sins, but if he repents sincerely, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's rahmat is much, much higher than his forgiveness, his mistakes, sins. Mm-hmm. Because you can't compare anything with the rahmat of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. It is the, it has the, what you call, unlimited, it is infinite. Allahu Akbar. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will forgive, even if the sins are equal to the oceans or equal to the trees of the earth, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is going to forgive that. But the condition is you have to seek repentance very sincerely. Allahu Akbar.
That's as far as repenting is concerned. Then how you need to sincerely repent about your sins and not just say, okay, I'm going to repent now and next time I'm going to make that sin again and repeat again. No, let's not make that a habit. Let's try and inshallah repent sincerely and make it a habit where we get engaged only in good deeds and try as much as possible to stay away from bad deeds. Brother Hassan, that brings me to the next question. We engage ourselves in sins day in, day out, and we do repent. But people, when they say do istighfar, repent, ask for forgiveness, is it just saying astaghfirullah, Allah, astaghfirullah, Allah, astaghfirullah? Is it just that? Many people get confused when you say do istighfar, say what do you mean by do istighfar?
Yeah, yes, of course. You can say astaghfirullah, or astaghfirullah rabbi min kulli dhanbin wa khati'atin wa atubu ilayhi. Or astaghfirullah rabbi min kulli dhanbin wa atubu ilayhi. Ya Allah, I seek repentance from you. And ya Allah, forgive my sins. Even if you say simply astaghfirullah, and if you have the meaning of this, that ya Allah, I seek repentance, I seek repentance. So as many times you repeat that, inshallah al-aziz, that is also a way of seeking forgiveness. But as I mentioned before, as per the guidelines given by Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam, before asking dua, before seeking repentance or asking dua, praise Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala by a few words like Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, Ya Hayy, Ya Qayyum, like beautiful attributes, the words, the names of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And then say, Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen, salawat and salam be upon Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the leader of all the prophets, who is the soul of the creation. And then when you ask dua, it will be said Ameen by the angels, sure. And inshallah al-aziz, it will be accepted. So even if you say simply astaghfirullah, if a person is engaged, making himself engaged in saying istighfar for about 100 times a day, so he can just say astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. He can take a tasbih and make it a count of 100 times. If it is after every prayer, that's much, much better, inshallah. And again, if he does that, not only that he is getting the forgiveness from Allah, but his daraja also will be raised. Because those people who seek forgiveness and those who have not got sins, they have already been forgiven or they have not committed a sin, it doesn't mean that their istighfar will go on waste. No, their darajas will be raised and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will be pleased with them more and more for taking Allah ta'ala as most forgiver, subhanallah. And again, as far as the repentance is concerned, we should make this a habit, like to do it very often, because you know today the situation is such, we are always engaged in the sin. So make a habit of this, to at least in heart, by heart even, we should say that, Ya Allah, I have committed this sin, Ya Allah, forgive me. So that you will get a thought for not committing such a sin again. And you see about the repentance, how Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is pleased with a person. I will refer a hadith of Bukhari Sharif, where it is narrated about a person of Bani Israel who had already murdered 99 persons, who had committed a sin, such a major sin that he murdered 99 people. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wasallam, while referring about him, says that he went to a person called Rahib, because Rahib, usually in Bani Israel, the ulama, the scholars, they were called Rahib. But that was not a proper Rahib where he went. He said, this person went and said to Rahib, I have committed 99 murders. Will Allah ta'ala forgive me? See the thirst of being forgiven, to seek the forgiveness from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. That Rahib said, no, you have committed 99 murders, there is no forgiveness for you. So this person killed that person as well. he murdered that person as well. It was 100 now. But again, he is having the thirst of seeking forgiveness. He has a feeling guilty in his heart that I have done a mistake, Allah should forgive me. So again, he, while searching for this, some person advised him, you go to a place, a village where there are pious servants of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and you can take assistance from them about your repentance. Go and ask them about the repentance, subhanallah. I'm just briefing the hadith here again. When this person intended to travel to that place, now he is from his city or his village to another village, he's going to travel where there are pious servants of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. His intention is to get the forgiveness from Allah. He is finding a person to guide him, that will Allah forgive me? For his question, he needs an answer for that. So on his way, when he was right in the middle, the death of angel came and his soul was taken. Allahu Akbar. And when he fell down, his chest was towards that city where he was intending to go, that is towards the city of the pious servants of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Now the angels of punishment also came, angels of rahmat also came, they all descended. Now there is an argument between these angels of punishment, azab and rahmat. Punishment angel says that he had murdered 100 people. Now it is, he is in our custody, we will take him towards the punishment. The angels of mercy say, yes, he has committed a sin, he has committed major sins indeed, but see, he was going to seek the assistance from pious servants of Allah in order to get the repentance from Allah Ta'ala, because his intention was to get the repentance from Allah. Now there is a quarrel, I mean there is an argument between the angels, Allahu Akbar. Now Allah Ta'ala has ordered the earth, because he is in the middle now, his chest is towards the pious servants of Allah, the city where they are living. Now Allah Ta'ala has ordered the earth from that side where the pious servants of Allah there to get shortened here, and from this side to get lengthier. Allahu Akbar. Now the order from Allah to measure the place, like to measure the earth, that which is closer to him. Now already Allah Ta'ala has ordered there. And now when angels, when they measured, they found he was closer about one, like how to say, palm, not palm, like this, up to this one hand, one just hand. For example. So he was closer to the city of the pious servants of Allah. Now the order from Allah to make him towards the salvation, because though he was a sinner, but his intention was to seek forgiveness, and he was intending to go to pious servants of Allah in order to get help from them. So see, if a person is seeking forgiveness from Allah, and if he is going towards a pious servant of Allah through their wasila to seek the forgiveness, how much Allah loves him, how much Allah is pleased with him. Though he was a sinner of 100, he has killed 100 people, but again, this is a rahmat of Allah, maghfirat from Allah, that Allah Ta'ala has forgiven that person as well. Now there can be a question that huququl ibad, the rights of Allah, if a person does not pray or does not observe fast, Allah Ta'ala, if wills, he will give the punishment, if he wills, he will forgive. But rights of the people, they have to forgive in order to get the forgiveness from Allah.
Absolutely.
If I have hurt you, I have to seek forgiveness from you first. You have to forgive me.
Only after then Allah Ta'ala will forgive.
So he has murdered 100 people here now. So those have to forgive him.
Absolutely.
Subhanallah. What does it mean in light of this hadith is, if Allah Ta'ala is happy with a person, if Allah Ta'ala comes to forgiveness, he will make those people whose right was on him, make those people also be happy by blessing them with lots of ni'mah. And Allah Ta'ala will make them forgive this person. So what we got to know from here is, seeking forgiveness is a great achievement, great thing. If a person is crying in fear of Allah and seeking forgiveness, Allah Ta'ala becomes so pleased with him that Allah Ta'ala is forgiving his sins, elevating his status and transferring his sins towards the good deeds. And again, even if he has done so much of murders, if Allah comes to forgiveness, Allah Ta'ala will make those people whose rights was over him, will make them forgive this person, subhanallah. And this is a mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. While reading this hadith, I was so much, motivated that how Allah Ta'ala wants to forgive people. And if a person has got sincere intention, and again, if he is going towards the pious servants of Allah, because they are already selected by Allah, they have been blessed by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, so by being closer to them, we are also getting the forgiveness from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And again, if you refer to the Quran, you see Allah Ta'ala has stated, Inna Allah Ghafoorur Rahim, Allah is the one to forgive. And again, Allah Ta'ala has mentioned in so many places, Wallahu Ghafoorur Rahim, Allah is the one Ghafoor, Allah is Ghaffar, Allah is Rahim, Rahman, Tawwab, He is the one to accept the repentance, Allahu Akbar. But Allah Ta'ala has stated in Quran about the sinners, Walau annahum idhalamu anfusahum ja'uka. Oh my Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if these people commit sins, and if they want the repentance, they should come to you, O Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Quran says, Ja'uka, O Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they should come towards you. And Fastaghfarullah, in your holy court, they should seek repentance from Allah. Fastaghfarullah. This is not ended by here. The same verse is continuing. Wastaghfara lahumur rasul. And my Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam should also intercede for them.
Subhanallah.
Lawajadullaha tawwabar rahima. Then you will find Allah, the forgiver, the most forgiving, subhanallah. So to find Allah Ta'ala as forgiver and most merciful, Allah Ta'ala is order for we people to go to the holy court of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Verse of Quran, none can reject this. Fastaghfarullah, at the holy court of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seek repentance from Allah by being there. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has to intercede for you. He has to make sifarish, shafa'at for you. Then you will find Allah as forgiver. So this again means, how about those people who are unable to visit Madinatul Munawwara? Okay. And this verse, though there are verses of Quran which was related as per the circumstance, but the order is for all the people till the day of judgment. Mm-hmm. So about this verse, for those people who are unable to visit Madina, Muhaddiseen, Mufassireen, they have given us beautiful guideline that if you are unable to visit Madina, then you think of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam as you have presented yourself in his court, mm-hmm. and seek repentance from Allah. Insha'Allah, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam will seek forgiveness for you, and Allah Ta'ala will forgive your sins. And this is not just a practice of us. You see, Adam ala Nabiyyina wa alaihi salatu wasalam, though Anbiya Ikram, they cannot commit a sin. We have discussed this earlier about the prophets and their specialities, the reason for that, why asking forgiveness and all. So when Adam alayhi salatu wasalam sought repentance from Allah, he also made use of the name of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasalam, that Ya Allah, by the wasila of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, you forgive my sins. And Allah asked, O Adam, how you got to know about my Habib sallallahu alayhi wasalam? Then Adam alayhi salam said, Ya Allah, when you created me, I saw in Jannah, besides your name, I found the name of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Then Allah Ta'ala stated, yes, if not for him, I would have not created you. If not for him, I would have not created anything. Allahu Akbar. So we got to know, in light of Quran, to seek repentance, you have to seek repentance from Allah. Allah is the most forgiver. Allah Ta'ala will forgive sins. Allah will be pleased with him. And if you take the wasila of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there is a guarantee for forgiveness. And again, everything as it is mentioned very clearly in Quran, Allah is the one to forgive, but the forgiveness is based on the intercession of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of the shafaat of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One cannot say that how come Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the base for the forgiveness. If you refer to the hadith of shafaat, we have already discussed about the shafaat, mm-hmm. where the whole mahshar was created, a whole setup was made just to show the lofty status of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that if he opens the door of the shafaat, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will forgive people, and after him, all the other prophets and awliya Allah, the ulama, the huffaz, they will also do intercede, do shafa'at. So in light of the hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam has stated, my hayati khairul lakum, my life is great, good for you, it's better for you. Wa mamati khairul lakum, my leaving this world is also better for you. During my lifetime, I give you the order from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. I give you the guidelines. I guide you all the way. Subhanallah. So it is better for you. And after leaving this world, when I see your good deeds, I will be pleased, I will thank Allah Ta'ala, and when I see your bad deeds, I will seek repentance from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So this again means, where he states, after my leaving this world, that is better for you, because your deeds are presented towards me, and by seeing your good deeds, I will thank Allah, and by seeing your bad deeds, I will be sad, and again I will seek repentance for you. So repentance from Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam towards us, this is also in light of Quran. Allah Ta'ala has stated that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi has ordered Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ. The verbal meaning of this, the literal meaning of this is, O Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seek forgiveness for your sins. But this is not the actual meaning, because if you go word by word towards the Quran, we won't be able to understand the Holy Quran. If it was so easy to understand the Quran by going word by word, then what was the necessity of writing the tafsir in volumes? Absolutely. That is also in Arabic. For each and every verse, there are volumes written in tafsir. The Holy Quran contains just one holy book, but the tafsir of it is containing 30 volumes. There are 80 volumes as well for the tafsir. Still, you cannot complete the verses of the Quran. So meaning here is, O my Habib sallallahu alayhi wasallam, seek forgiveness for your closed ones, walil mu'minina wal mu'minat, and for the general Muslims, male and female, seek forgiveness for them. So that again means Allah Ta'ala wants Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam to seek forgiveness for us, so that with his dua, Allah Ta'ala will accept. So in this month of Ramadan, every day we should seek repentance, especially on this month of Ramadan. As Allah Ta'ala's Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated, the first 10 days of Ramadan is of rahmat, the second 10 days is of maghfirat, to seek repentance, and the third 10 days is to get the salvation from the hellfire. So we are in the month of Ramadan, so we should seek more and more forgiveness from Allah. We have got a very, very good opportunity in order to seek forgiveness. As Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, that once Sayyiduna Jibreel Amin alayhi salatu wa sallam came to the holy court of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, while he was getting into the mimbar, he said Ameen thrice. So one of the reason of Ameen was, a person who gets Ramadan and does not make himself forgiven, free from the hellfire, May Allah Ta'ala keep him away from his mercy. The Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said Amin to the dua of Sayyidina Jibreel Alayhi Salatu Wasallam. So this again means this is a very good opportunity to seek forgiveness from Allah and to get the salvation from the hellfire. And again, we discussed about this, that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is pleased with that person who seeks forgiveness. So not only for us, we should seek forgiveness for our family, our parents, our relatives, and already those who have passed. And this is also was the this was also a practice of Sahaba Karam. Rabbana ghafir lana, this is a verse of Quran. Allah Ta'ala has praised those Sahabas who sought forgiveness for the people before them, those Muslims before them. Rabbana ghafir lana, O Allah, forgive us. Wali ikhwanina, and those brothers of us. Alladina sabakuna bil iman, those who have left us in the state of iman. Subhanallah. So seeking forgiveness for the those believers who left before us. This is a sunnah of Sahaba, and this was praised by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So Alhamdulillah, we got a very good chance here today in this month of Ramadan. And not only during Ramadan, even after the Ramadan, we should make it a practice to seek forgiveness from Allah. And my sincere advice to the people, if people are suffering from any kind of calamities, if they do istighfar, Allah Ta'ala will remove their calamities. Sure. If they are having some kind of sorrow, some kind of difficulties, with the barakah of istighfar, it will be relieved. And again, if a person is finding difficulty in his rizq, in his provision, it is in hadith to repent from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. By repentance, he will get the forgiveness as well as he will get the barakah in his rizq. And Allah Ta'ala has stated in Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. The one who fears Allah, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will open the door of rizq towards him, which is beyond his expectation. He won't be aware that from where the rizq is coming towards him. The doors of the rizq will be open towards him, that he can't guess that from where the rizq is coming. Allah Ta'ala will give such a way, in such way Allah Ta'ala will bless him with rizq. If he repents, fears Allah, and if he is seeking sincerely repentance repents from Allah, if he sincerely repents Allah. And it is in hadith. Also Sayyidina Imam Jafar Sadiq radiallahu ta'ala who states, a great wali of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala from the family of Nabi Kareem sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he states, if you want barakah in your rizq and to get relieved from the calamities, do more and more istighfar. So this was in light of Quran, this is in light of hadith, and this was the practice of the pious servants of Allah who guided us by saying to seek repentance. And at all the times, as I always mention, not to forget reciting salawat on Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because every dua after praising Allah and after sending salawat on Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we seek repentance, if we ask our dua, inshallah Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will definitely accept. And this is also a hadith narrated by Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, where he says the dua remains between the earth and the sky unless the salawat al-Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned. So dua is not accepted unless salawat al-Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is said. So by following the ways of Sahaba Akram, we should make it a practice. Sure. Always we try to seek repentance from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and remember this as well. By repenting, you are getting your sins forgiven. Your heart will become pure. You will get, because after repenting, when the sins are forgiven, now when you listen to a good thing, your heart will be melted towards it. If not, if we have committed lots of sins, so even if we hear good things, we will just stay away. We will just ignore those things because our heart has become dark now. So by seeking repentance sincerely, this will be cleared, and whatever good we hear in light of Quran and hadith, that will come into our heart, and we can make it a practice in our day-to-day life.
Inshallah, may Allah help us make it a practice in our day-to-day lives. Brother Ehsan has pretty much summarized for us the importance of repenting for us Muslims, because as you said in the very beginning, you know, unless you do shirk, there's always a U-turn in Islam. You can always go back to Allah.
May Allah protect all of us.
More and more opportunities to get back to Him by repentance, and it is very important for all of us to repent. And as Brother Ehsan summarized for us, you need to give Him beautiful attributes, beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You praise Him, and then you obviously need to send salawat on the Prophet, and then you make dua. And then inshallah ta'ala, your duas will be answered. And inshallah, you will remove all the sins and all the bad things from your heart. And inshallah, you'll get closeness to Allah. Because that's what we're all looking for, aren't we, in this beautiful month of Ramadan. Brother Ehsan, thank you so much once again for shedding light on this very important topic of repentance. Inshallah, we'll be back tomorrow, because that's all the time we have for now. Because we also need to repent, and you also need to repent. Please do go and repent. And inshallah, we'll see you tomorrow here on Islam in Focus. Until then, may the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu Allah.